الحمد للہ والصلاة والسلام رسول الکریم، اما بعد، اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. مائی ڈیئر برادرز اینڈ سسٹرز ان اسلام اینڈ ان ہیومینٹی، السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. مے پیس، مرسی اینڈ بلیسنگ آف اللہ بی اپون یو. ٹوڈے مائی ٹاپک از توحید. Islam believes in Tawheed, which is not merely monotheism, i.e. belief in one unique God, but much more. Tawheed literally means unification, i.e. asserting oneness, and is derived from the Arabic verb wahda, which means to unite, unify, or consolidate. Tawheed can be divided into three categories. Number one, Tawheed al-Rububiyah. Number two, Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat. Number three, Tawheed al-Ibadah. Tawheed al-Rububiyah, maintaining the unity of Lordship. Rububiyah is derived from the root verb Rab, meaning Lord, Sustainer, and Cherisher. Therefore, Tawheed al-Rububiyah means maintaining the unity of Lordship. This category is based on the fundamental concept that Allah alone caused all things to exist when there was nothing. He created or originated all that exists out of nothing. He alone is the sole creator, cherisher, and sustainer of the universe and all between it, without any need from it or for it. Number two, Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat, maintaining the unity of Allah's name and attributes. Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat means maintaining the unity of Allah's name and attributes. This category is divided into five aspects. Number one, Allah should be referred to as described by Him and His Prophet. Allah must be referred to according to the manner in which He and His Prophet have described Him, without explaining His names and attributes by giving them meanings other than their obvious meanings. Number two, Allah must be referred to as He has referred to Himself. Allah must be referred to without giving Him any new names or attributes. For example, Allah may not be given the name Al-Ghadib, the angry one, despite the fact that He has said that He gets angry, because neither Allah nor His messenger, peace be upon him, have used this name. Number three, Allah is referred to without giving Him the attributes of His creation. In a reference to God, we should strictly abstain from giving Him the attributes of those He has created. For instance, in the Bible, God is portrayed as repenting for His bad thoughts in the same way as humans do when they realize their error. This is completely against the principle of Tawheed. God does not repent and He does not commit any mistakes or errors. The key principle when dealing with Allah's attributes is given in the Holy Quran in Surah Ash-Shura. There is nothing whatever like unto Him, and He is the one that hears and sees all things. Al-Quran 42 verse 11. Although hearing and seeing are human qualities, when attributed to the divine being, they are without comparison in their perfection, unlike when associated with humans who require ears, eyes, etc., and who are limited in their sight and hearing. Number four, man should not to be given any attribute of God. To refer to a human with the attribute of God is also against the principle of Tawheed. For example, referring to a person as one who has no beginning or end, eternal. Number five, Allah's name cannot be given to His creature. Some divine names in the identified form, the like Rauf or Rahim, are permissible names for man as Allah has used them for prophets. But Ar-Rauf, the most pious, and Ar-Rahim, the most merciful, can only be used if prefixed by Abd, meaning slave, of or servant of, i.e. Abdul Rauf or Abdul Rahim. Al-Quran 42 verse 11. Number 3. Tawheed al-Ibadah, maintaining the unity of worship. Ibadah is derived from Arabic word abad, meaning slave or servant. Thus, Ibadah means servitude and worship. Salah is one of the highest forms of Ibadah, i.e. worship, but is not the only form. People misunderstand that worship of Almighty God only means ritual prayers, but the concept of worship in Islam includes total obedience, submission and servitude, following the commandments of God and abstaining from things He has forbidden is Ibadah, worship. And this worship is only due to Allah alone and to no one else. All three categories to be followed simultaneously. Only believing in the first two categories of Tawheed without implementing Tawheed al-Ibadah is useless. The Quran gives the examples of the mushrikeens, idolaters, of the Prophet's time, who confirmed the first two aspects of Tawheed. It is mentioned in the Holy Quran. Say, who is it that sustains you in life from the sky and from the earth? Or who is it that has power over hearing and sight? And who is it that brings out the living from the dead and the dead from the living? And who is it that rules and regulates all affairs? They will soon say, Allah. Say, will you not then show piety to him? Al-Quran 10 verse 31. A similar example is repeated in Surah Al-Az-Zakhruf of the Holy Quran. If you ask them who created them, they will certainly say, Allah. How then are they diluted away from the truth? Al-Quran 43 verse 87. The pagan Meccans knew that Allah was their creator, sustainer, lord, and master. Yet, they were not Muslims because they also worshipped other gods besides Allah. Allah categorized them as kafirin, disbelievers, and mushrikeen, idol worshippers, and those who associate partners with God. And most of them believed not in Allah without associating others as partners with him. Al-Quran 12 verse 106. Thus, Tawheed al-Ibadah, i.e. maintaining the unity of worship, is the most important aspect of Tawheed. He alone deserves worship and he alone can grant benefit to man for his worship. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.